get started with a roll call.
Johnson.
Here.
Greg Collier.
Here.
Andrew Barker.
Here.
Joel Gardner. Steve Smith. Over.
Here.
Greg Willoughby.
Here.
And there'll be no minutes till a later date. We got Sam Weathers with us today, kind of familiar face. Appreciate you coming by.
We got an open seat down here on the end.
Like old times. Comments from the audience. Suzanne, you want to present this? I'll do this, just inject it in at this time since we have nobody speaking, but there seems to be a noise issue with the restaurant feeding down into the lobby area. And this has been mentioned before to us. Never did anything about it. Of course, the restaurant was closed sometime while we were doing the remodeling. And our simplest fix was to put a barrier up there and not buy with glass. So James got a bid. Is this glass or plexiglass? This is tempered glass, which would be the best way to go. $6,795, which would be $7,000, what we're talking about. We have money that's discretionary money left over from our remodels. We could consider this as being a continuation of the remodel and not think of it as a new item or something. It would be a way to look at it. We do have stuff earmarked for those monies, but I thought James asked me about it before the meeting, and I thought it would be a good to bring it up, and we could tentatively act on it today, in my opinion. But if you think you need more time to think about it, then fine. But I'd like to hear some discussion on it. I think it's something that probably, if we do it, needs to be done as quickly as possible.
So is it just across where the old plexiglass used to be?
Well, there's never been anything there.
Oh, I thought we had plexiglass across there.
No.
So the south side of the restaurant, across that wall.
Right, and then over the door, there's no glass over the top of the walk-through door, so that's sealing that up as well.
And then that'll tie into the wall glass and that around that's going outside.
Right.
Is it just a certain height? I mean, just enough to buffer the
all
noise,
the
or it's from floor to ceiling?
Sealing it off.
I guess my only question would be, what's that going to do to our HVAC situation up there? Is that?
It has its own unit.
Does it already have its own unit? Okay. I don't see any problem. Not going to cut off anybody's light or view or anything like that. Truthfully speaking, it might make it safer.
It's obviously a tempered glass from any sort of a safety issue.
Yes.
We could also look at it. This is only one. You only got one quote. We could ask for, how would you word this? We could maybe give the green light to spend up to $7,000, or if James take it to other glass companies, at least give some other people a shot at it to see if we might get a better deal. Or
I would support getting a second estimate. I mean, we're going to spend close to $7,000. Let's just make sure that it can't be done for five.
How do we get them, James? Did you just know them? Did you just call them?
Yeah, that's who we use to remodel the offices in the terminal up in that hangar. They do other jobs for the city as well.
I like that concept. I'd say we green light for that amount and let James another bid and go for it.
He wouldn't have called these people if they hadn't been.
Obviously, they've done business with us before, so.
Done the job.
Is it like in sections, or is it one piece of glass?
No, it would be in pieces.
Have to be in sections.
You would tie it in. Same design as the sheet metal that's all the way around the restaurant already.
Okay.
That sounds reasonable to me. A shower door is $600.
Yeah. That's exactly right.
You know.
That is exactly right.
Well, it's tempered.
Yep.
Well, I have a tempered glass.
It would have to be tempered glass. It is.
Well, and I'm not a big proponent of getting the cheapest bid. The city's proven here recently that that's not always ideal. Maybe if we get a cheaper bid, we can compare the two and make sure they're apples to apples.
Same quality.
I was trying to avoid that. Also, that's why I made my statement, a better deal. Whatever you call a better deal, whether it be less expensive or we feel it's a better product or something like that. That was, but I certainly, I agree with
Is there another company that we've done business with in the past?
We've used a glass place that replaced the mirrors in the bathroom. They may be willing to quote it.
Thinking maybe somebody that we've already done business with and know their quality of work would.
Put in our sliding doors here.
I do not.
Back Jen and see who did that.
I'd like to make a motion that we let James use our building fund, I guess I'm going to say it, as funds that we still have left over, and that he has the authority to go up to $7,000 and put tempered glass in for the restaurant, and also just to have us at least two bids. Know that we're within reason of where we need to be.
Second.
Motion second. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Johnson?
Yes.
Yes.
Barker?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
Hanover?
Yes.
Willoughby?
Yes.
Okay. Airport operations. James?
I got a hold of Rick, the manager of the pallet company, and he's supposed to be getting a hold of the owner of the business, of the building, and then have him get back in touch with me. I left him two messages since then, so I haven't heard back yet. So I'm still working on that project. As far as all of our hangars go, we have them all rented and filled other than our open tee hangars. So we're working on building our hangar waiting list back up. So that's all looking good. We did have three people that was behind on their hangar rent, and they got all turned over to city attorney. So they're working on getting that collection. Other than that, everything else is going good.
How long has the city attorney had it?
It was last week. Sarah sent me the email. Yeah.
Do we have a waiting list now for hangars, or we just...
We've always had one, but there's more of a waiting list for large hangars, larger hangars than what our T hangars are. So, but now we're getting a waiting list to wait for T hangars again.
Any other questions? Before I turn this next one over to Wyman, I want to say I'm sure proud to see him back. As you know, Wyman has had a little bout with some issues, been in the hospital. One of the reasons we did not, I didn't make note of it to any of you, but the one reason we canceled the meeting last month was because of Wyman. He, not that he's totally indispensable, but he is a huge help. And we felt like we didn't have that much going on. I appreciate everyone returning information. No, that's fine. So we did not have the meeting last month, but I want to certainly welcome you back and proud to see you. You look good. Proud to see you as healthy as you are, and hope that'll be the last time you leave us hanging for a while. Okay. Okay, Wyman. Operation activity report.
Finished the year with operations about 26,400, down a little bit from the year before, but up from the year before that. So operations are continuing to stay about the same. Fuel purchases were up about almost $30,000, or 30,000 gallons. 471,000 in 2015 to 500,000 in this year. Financial statement shows that we've caught up on all our grants. I don't think we've got anything outstanding right now. Getting ready to for another one to do the engineering for the runway rehabilitation that they wanted us to pull forward for a year. Finished the year, gained about over $100,000 on our income. We look back, we're up, we're down, we're up and down each year. Just, a lot of that depends on the grants we've got that were in process and how much we've had to spend that we're waiting to get reimbursed for. Back in a positive mode. Last land lease that we did to Jeff Mann, been working with FAA to get his airspace clearance and stuff. They had a little issue with some of the documents they first filed. They had the wrong elevations in them and they got rejected, and he had to, his engineer had to redo them and send them back. So he is working toward getting started constructing hangars on Powell Street that he execute the lease, and it's effective.
Sounds good. Any questions? Well, we did get the shed removed. That was on the last meeting. I know it's still on here. The shed has been removed, and an update on the airport long range plan. Adam's not here, but he sent me an email. I didn't get it printed off for all of you, but I will read it. If it's not that long, but he said, I'll be in Little Rock tomorrow, so I won't be in attendance at the commission meeting. We don't have much going on right now, but I did want to email you a quick update of some project related items. Feel free to share with the commission your discretion. The airport's capital improvement plan that the commission approved in December was submitted to the FAA in January. As a reminder, this included the design of the runway pavement and lighting rehabilitation project this summer. With construction following next summer, the estimated cost of the construction is approximately $2.8 million. As a reminder, this project includes the following: overlay of the runway and connector taxiways, replacement of all cable in the runway circuit, replacement of existing incandescent MRLs and LED MRLs. The FAA will determine the appropriate engineering scope of services for the runway design by the end of February. At that time, the city will obtain an independent fee estimate. Once the estimate is obtained, we will send the city our proposal for the design work. Once negotiated, we'll assist the city in preparing a grant application to the FAA for design. Our current schedule with the FAA calls for the grant application to be submitted by April the 1st, 2017. Therefore, we expect to bring our proposal to the Airport Commission at your March meeting. The state is starting to loosen the purse strings on grant funds. If the Airport Commission would like to take advantage of a 90-10 grant for up to $200,000, we recommend getting something in front of the ADA Commission in the next couple of months. As always, feel free to call. I will forward this to Wyman so he can get it in our folders. And it seems to be like everything's run on track. I think we've, except the new word about the maybe $200,000 Arkansas Development Association grant for aeronautical grants. We talked about another hangar enclosure. We talked about some other things, but we need to look and see what would be eligible for that 90-10, because we certainly would, I would like to take advantage of it. So we've got a couple of months, he said, to apply for that, so maybe next month we can get that on the agenda to see what we might deem would be requested.
Hangars that we've got open so well that they're buying bigger airplanes, and we've got a lot bigger demand for the larger hangars than we do for those T hangars.
So
I think if we enclosed them, it makes it attractive. Small things that would fit in those. Enough money to really look at a project to build a bigger hangar or not, I'd have to.
$200,000 wouldn't be.
Have to add some to it.
But if we could get the money now, looking down the road, go ahead and get them closed in. As this city grows, there're gonna be small airplanes, you know, along with the fleet, I believe. Is there any other projects that anyone knows of that we might look at? And I don't think $200,000 is a ceiling. I think he just threw that out there as a.
Ceiling for the grant. We can go.
Right. So we might wanna look at going ahead and building another large hangar down there and finding the money for that. 90-10, that's pretty strong.
Good match.
Anything else on, we have for Adam? If not, the entrance sign, Andrew handed out some examples here. Committee on that, get a report.
So in no particular order, except the one we like best is on top. This is kind of the pared down version of what we got back, and we kind of like the design with the propeller, but we also really like the simplicity of design number 8 as well. Looking at cost to build the sign, it seems pretty apparent to us that number 8 would be the most affordable sign that could be either internally or externally lit very easily. So, anyone have any feedback?
I got one on this.
Yep.
To me, that looks like a barnstormer airport.
It does, I agree.
We're not that, I don't
think.
That. This brings us more up to modern, what we're trying to check the people. That's
how we felt as well.
Okay. So that's all I have.
That's really how we felt as well, honestly.
What dimensions are we looking at? I like number 8.
Okay.
But what physical size are we looking at?
Don't know that we've really determined a physical size yet. Have we,
Bill? I gave the dimensions from the previous quote that we got on the dimensions. The people at school used those dimensions as a scale here for these designs. So, and gosh, the old.
I didn't bring a copy of the old one with me
either. Yeah, I think I've got it. Let me see. But anyway, it should be in scale with a previous quote that we got.
The previous quote we had with the kind of eight board sign that was the change out kind of deal there. But I don't remember exactly what those were, honestly.
And I guess one question I've got in looking at our, it's not a retention pond, what the area there that they built. Is that sign, can we get it reasonably close to the edge of that retention area so it won't block traffic, your view coming out of the entrance onto Powell Street?
Yeah, I agree with that.
We're going to have to be careful with that.
Definitely don't want it too close to the road.
It shouldn't affect anything to back it up how far we need.
Okay.
It's our property, so as long as we don't encroach on the street, then we should be able to put our sign. And I'm not sure what the ordinance says, so you have to read that.
Whatever the setback is, yeah.
Right.
Weren't you were talking about that when we built that hangar, we had to put that water
right
retention pond.
Yeah, that we wouldn't affect.
Rain garden.
Yeah, rain garden. Wouldn't affect that by if we put the sign in it or on it or around it. Now, would this be, you say it could be internally lighted either way, or just floods on it either way?
Technically speaking, we could do whatever we wanted. This is just kind of a concept of how we want it to look. I think now we'll take it, if everyone agrees on the design, we'll take it to the back to the sign folks and let them actually give us a new bid. Maybe ask them to do it both ways, internally lit or just with floods. I don't know.
Keep in mind that we've got another business on the other side of the property that fronts on Powell that's going to be building several hangars there, and he's going to want a sign over there. I think that this sign is going to be just for businesses that are located up that driveway.
I guess that's kind of what we assumed, yes, but I don't.
They want to, depending on how you position it or put an arrow or something or whatever on that side.
Right.
I was going to suggest too, here where the airport, if there were an arrow pointing into that drive.
A good idea.
Because we're there, but I'd also want them to know that this is where you turn.
That would be that would be a good indication that these businesses were also in that area as well.
Be simple too, just a simple arrow.
Yeah, sure.
You could do that just on the very top.
Yeah, top or bottom either one.
Of the upper block there, you could.
Or even right here after airport.
Could you guys come back with the dimension, color, and pricing and all that at the next meeting, or?
I don't see why not.
Maybe we could instruct you to go on a certain sign or something to accomplish today.
Yeah, sure, we can certainly do that.
What do you all need from the commission? Let me ask you that.
Well, I guess do we have any direction on color, or is there city colors? Does the city utilize any specific colors?
On the crossroads symbol?
Yeah.
Sorry.
It
may not be.
It may not be that for forever, though.
I'm not sure that we're going to need a great lot of color other than just maybe the Springdale Municipal Airport and the silhouette of the sign or the silhouette of the aircraft. The individual ads down here for our patrons or
whatever they choose.
Yeah, whatever they choose. So I don't know. I think it needs to be something pretty simple that has a clear contrast.
I would agree.
Black and white's pretty good.
That's
contrast than that.
Black and white actually looks pretty good.
I thought it looked good personally.
Internally lit, is that what you're leaning towards?
Honestly, it would depend on price to me personally, but I think it would look better internally lit, and you could also do the same thing on the block below for those signs. Would be the prettiest, but again, I would say it would depend on pricing. I think anything in this category is going to be cheaper, way cheaper than the other bids that we had on the other signs anyway. So I think we're going to come out ahead no matter what we do.
I know I've got the dimensions. I wouldn't skimp on the size of it.
Not when it can be seen from 412.
Right, right.
And I think the piece here where the airplane silhouette is and the Springdale Municipal Airport, that can be a little bit bigger. You know, it kind of maybe offers a little bit of an additional contrast.
Well, it won't cost any different, I mean, realistically speaking.
Right, and then can be a little bit wider than the advertising area.
I'd like to move with that we accept Design 8. So we have that set firm.
Okay.
Okay, now we've got, there's Ken Signs here in Springdale, and then I know Design in Lowell.
Who did we have quote the other one? Who was collecting those? Was that you, Bill?
Yeah. You know, I don't remember. Do you remember?
Just on the topic of the sign? On the design?
Yes.
I don't mind. Anyone have any objections going on?
Please.
Sorry, this is my first time here. My name's Cameron McCarron. I'm the owner of Arkansas Helicopters. So when I look at this sign, you know, it does give an appearance of an executive airport. I like that. And I think that's the approach that we need to go and, you know, not a barnstormer type airport. We are an executive and exclusive type airport to this area. And the reason I say that is because not only do we offer premium executive charter services out of the Springdale Airport, but we also offer, and this is a recommendation, we also offer executive charter services by helicopter as well. Not only do we offer those charter services, but here very shortly, the Springdale Municipal Airport will have the only helicopter Part 141 certified helicopter flight training school in the state. We take our check ride on March 1st, and the Springdale Municipal Airport does a lot more than just airplanes. So I would like to, me personally, would like to see some sort of design that kind of encompasses everything that we do at the airport. So that's just my thoughts.
My thought on that is we're trying to just get a sign to identify the airport. And we do have space on here to advertise businesses on the airport. Whether that helicopter operation is part of the airport or a business on the airport is what we would have to look at as to see where that was noted on the sign, would be my opinion. I think the top part is just simply generic at this Springdale Airport. And it doesn't even say executive, it doesn't say anything. It could have executive airport. It could have...
I would personally be against the executive airport name because that's what Fayetteville did.
Yes.
And I don't think it benefited them any.
Municipal airport is,
it is
says
what it is.
Plenty.
It's what we are, right?
And then we, if we need to make additional space for, in fact, it shows Arkansas helicopters on this rendering, but that would be my thoughts. Anybody else?
I really appreciate the feedback for sure, but I would agree that the airport sign itself, fairly basic, is the right direction. And if you wanted to put a helicopter or whatever, some graphics on, or if you wanted two spots on the sign to give your business more visibility, I think then that's certainly something we'd be all for.
All we're authorized to sponsor is the airport and not businesses on the airport. We're providing
right.
space for that at a cost. And appreciate your comments. Anybody else? We got a motion to for the committee to, in such ways as they see fit, to use number 8 as the primary design. Is that a good way to put it? Have a second?
I'll second.
Motion to second. Any discussion? Voice vote.
Johnson. Johnson.
Yes.
Collier.
Yes.
Barker.
Yes.
Smith.
Yes.
Dover.
Yes.
Willoughby.
Yes. While we're talking about the signs, though, this is going to be at the main entrance. But I've often thought that down at the intersection, for example, of 412 and 265, there should be
a better sign.
A sign or an arrow that points to how you get there, you know.
I wonder if we get this city council change that road to airport road.
Oh.
Powell Street.
Powell Street. I don't know. That's an a possibility. Kathy says no. but I think you know, because our entrance is not, the airport is more visible there. People can see it, but that doesn't tell them how to get there.
Well, we've got signs back in town saying how to get there, but I don't think we have anything right
actually,
there.
Actually, all of those
right.
new signs they put up, they
we
didn't
need,
mention the airport.
Somehow or other, we need to get signage up there. If it's signage that's provided by the city or state
yeah.
or whatever.
Well, even if it's just
could the committee look
simple.
Into that?
Yeah.
Part of it also. I believe it's
I
a good
work,
idea.
You know, right there, so I can certainly look at
I mean, I just think that that's something that's sure. that's relevant because there's the airport, but how do I get there?
Right. Many times as I go through there, I don't remember where the sign is except the one down by Walgreens, you know.
Yeah, there's one down by Walgreens and there's one right there at Powell, but I don't think there's one at 265 and 412. I think you're right.
Yeah, I was thinking there, and
there's a fair amount of traffic there for sure.
Yeah.
And like you say, the airport's most visible right there.
412 and Powell.
No, 412 and
265. 265 and
412. Just an arrow or a sign or...
Could there
it
be...
It could be on our property. You know?
Well, yeah, we got lots of property right there.
They could we fabricate something that's attached to the fence that would be large enough to see from the intersection? It would be a simple directional.
Certainly could.
And it would be fairly inexpensive, just to...
Why don't you expand your duties as committee to come up with a recommendation?
We have a really nice design that we're getting ready to use for the other sign.
Make it miniature.
We did the exact same thing.
Sure.
Right there.
Just back up inside the fence.
Sure, or on the fence.
Out of the highway right away, you're on our property, and you could put something as large as you wanted to, saying that that's the airport and the entrance is...
Yep.
Couldn't you hang it right on the fence?
It'd be on the fence, actually.
I thought we were talking about Powell Street, I'm sorry, while we go entering, you were talking about that sign at the end of the airport.
412 and 265.
Yeah.
You could actually put it on the fence.
Yep.
You can put .3 miles on the right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Don't allow that in Springdale, do we?
Got plenty of property down there to put it on.
Yeah.
Just a thought.
I'll look at that and see kind of what space we have available right there, and...
Be nice to have a sign there just to identify that it is Springdale Airport.
Could we put it on the tower? The localizer tower?
That whole corner on 265.
But if we attached it to the legs of the localizer tower, I wonder how that would be, if that would work, the FAA, let's do that.
They don't like the tower at all.
Let me look and see what's possible there.
That'd be good. Just expand your...
I just thought...
No, it's a very good idea.
Idea.
Very good idea.
Anybody else on the signage? We'll expect to hear from the committee then next month. Any old business?
What about furniture, where are we at with that?
That's what I was gonna say, end tables, it's a combination of my error and Joe Donaldson. Went to him around Christmas time, and they were just covered up, slammed, and he's needed to order some extra tables. I forgot to follow up with him, and when I did, he had forgotten to order them, so we should have the next tables in the next few days.
Yeah, I've got a couple of updates. The rugs, there's been two production delays, which are totally unavoidable. But now we have been notified that the rugs, or the carpet that'll be cut into rugs is available, and it was supposed to have been shipped last Friday. Well, hadn't gotten here, and so our vendor, our supplier checked yesterday, and they're still sitting at the factory. Now, we supposedly have an absolute promise that they will ship tomorrow. And we've asked the binder, the local fella here that's will shape them and bind them to allow us any priority that he can. So that's the update on that. The production was unavoidable. Don't really know what happened with the shipping situation, but hopefully, maybe by the next meeting that they will be in place.
Once that is, do you mind shooting an email to the commission letting us know that they're there?
Okay, oh yeah, when they come in, you'll be glad to, yep, sure will. And I've just got a couple of questions. Is there any update on our tower paint? Are we, you know...
I can answer that. He is waiting on the right time. We missed a beautiful window, and partly I'll take the blame for that. He also does painting for me, and I had him covered up on a deal. And, but we are, we're in a mild, a spring looks like, and so I discussed this with him just the other day, and he's ready to get after it. So in his time, he's busy with a lot of other people too, but I do know that even projects he was doing for me was, he was covered up. And you gotta keep in mind, he's got to deal not only with temperature, but wind.
Being that tall.
So we don't want to paint a bunch of cars and airplanes up there. So if you'll bear with us, I say that, James, I've been making James aware of it, and he's working with him too, but I did mention it myself. I went to him, or he came to me, really. He came in and said, hey, you know, am I okay on the airport? And I said, you're okay now. So that's the way I left it with him. Maybe I took too much on myself to do that, but he'll get it done and he'll do a good job, and it's a special paint, and we definitely want him to do it if we can.
The only other thing I've got is, James, I'd kind of like for you to follow up with the people at the pallet company. You know, I mean, I don't think it takes, should take a great lot of time to find out whether or not they're interested in partnering with us. And I, as I look at that, it is an eyesore. It really is, where, you know, forklifts come through the building and, you know, just, you know, if you could kind of try to get an answer from them.
Have you had a chance to talk to him yet, James?
I spoke with Rick, and he's supposed to be getting a hold of the owner, and I've been since waiting, so I've called and left him two other messages. Matter of fact, where he popped his warehouse out, the skunks have moved into it.
Yeah, I think Jim blocked the skunk entrance into his hangar, so they moved across the field over there.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else?
What about the dirt? I see some dirt moving back there on that big pile. What are we doing with that?
Street department's been using it for some of their ditches. And what's left, they're going to just level it out with the dozers. We're not extending.
That's not going to happen anytime soon. That's a big mound.
Question on the building there at the pallet company. What do we do if we don't get support from them? Do we try to build a fence, or, I mean, what are our options to make that look better if we don't get any positive response from them?
Look, see what the cost is going to be and see, and take it from there. We probably need to be doing that anyway, yeah.
Kind of wanted to plant the seed of, sounds like we're not getting a lot of cooperation already. Maybe I'm misreading the tone from James there, but
be real easy to get a quote on it because, you know, it's just a flat surface and so many square feet. Yeah. Be an easy job.
It would be.
I guess even if we painted it, it's still where the forklift came through. It'd still be, you know.
You can take the back on and push it back.
Yeah, if we could accidentally push that back in place a little bit, that would help, but, you know.
That's not something that code enforcement could get involved with?
Trying to play nice.
Can only do that so long.
Yes.
Well, maybe while they're loading that dirt out down there, they could offer to bring that loader up there and push it back in for them.
Fix the wall for them.
Pardon me?
Fix the wall for them.
Yeah. Might explore that. When you start pushing on the whole thing coming down, then we got a problem. Anybody else? If not, we'll adjourn.